you told us that we have seen it, that the Biafran app, Freedom app, is complete. And you say that we will launch it in October. And I want to ask, is it not possible again for launching of the app? Because what the attack our people are experiencing in X handle is too much. So I'm asking about when are you going to launch the app? So since the October is about to end, so that is my question, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The app is already, you know, the launching of the app is that the app must be on the app first. And that is the place where we are now. So as soon as the app has been approved and on the Play Store, on the Apple Store, then the app will be launched. And then we can begin to add more other functional features to it. For now, it is ready. And we are just waiting for the approval. Thank you.
God bless you, sir.
Okay, we go to Valentine. Valentine, over to you.
Good evening, PM. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, all the ministers. I can never know Gona, as a Mokoyachi, Yazelo, Umochineke, Koya Babanano, Chineke Chavai. Pico PM, if I'm Cholo, when we full question on Cholejo, then with your comment. Question first of all, I want to be a friend in the diaspora. We go. Any means MLO, I guess you were more can integrate na database Biafra. Now about the question when cause us able comment. Prime Minister, because our the IPOB Nigeria Limited. Now call more about that saying that boy in Finland. Because remain that boy in Finland, my name Kenya. Maybe Jack Okenye. Remember that boy in Finland. Well, if I can that boy, EGM, fire, then me fire, I won't as well. Thank you, PM.
And there were. Adam, you did by yourself. So, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. We can hear you, PM.
So, I'm going to put out your joint wire. So the integration of KID of Biafra is already in the in Biafra administration, BSA, Biafra Security Administration. So that is the reason we have the family application for Biafra ID card. So your children can also apply for ID card. It is there. So those things have been, you know, taken care of. Thank you.
Because PM, because somebody shared that link. Because I told me about food, but I know all African countries were here. Anyway, kids is the idea. Malo
signed off. Just Omoro, there is no way you can be part of this movement, and you are in our address. In our address, Biafra ID card. Don't you know or have contact to your liaison officer in your country or the people in the media? So anytime you call, it's there. The link has been shared everywhere. Biafra Security Administration. It's actually on Google.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you. Machine gone to a gunfight. Are you ready?
Yes, I am ready. Good evening, my PM. It is very beautiful. This stupid guy, Chidi, how he made everything so popular. You know how it is in Nigeria, you try to minimize your data. So I've never been on this space, and now I never knew it would be this interesting. So he made me to switch to this page, to this space. When all these things started, it was just like a joke. I thought it was just a Twitter thing, online thing, desperate thing. Until the Christmas, I went, in December, I went back to the East, to my side. Then my coordinator, he just started the story. They are always interested about, are you following Simon or are you following the DOS? So I was just laughing. I thought it was just a joke. We thought it was just Twitter things. I never knew it even got to the homeland, to the ground floor. Where is Chimaruke? He said, wow, following Simon Ewa. Ha. This year again, I saw my coordinator again. He started the same topic. He asked me to come to their meeting and all of this. So one day I went to their meeting and I only found three persons there. Three persons plus me, therefore. Everybody have left. I noticed, and in their meeting, they are only discussing, these guys are not discussing Biafra anymore. It was just so boring. They were only discussing Simon. Simon said this, Simon said that. This is what you're going to do. Simon is a criminal. Everybody have left the movement. Because then we were the small boys that were the secretaries. I saw someone say he's 23. I'm 24. We were the small boys in Aba that joined the movement. Some other time I was with him again, because when I came back, I always visited around there. I was with him and I was just discussing something I wanted to propose. That was why I asked me to come to a meeting. I wanted to propose to the movement. And then someone was just passing and got attracted and came to our back and was watching because of the discussion of the name Simon. Whenever you mention the name Simon, people want to listen. This is what is happening in the homeland in Aba. People want to listen. So after a while, the man should be like 50 something, but he's agile and tall. He called me by the side and he excused him and called me by the side and said, who do you think that you, what is your heart telling you, who do you support? So you don't really know who to trust and their mindset. I was like twisting words and saying, Simon is, if not because of Simon, Nnamdi Kanu would have been dealt with, if not because of him, the movement would have been dead and all these things. But also I was still trying to see where the man is coming from, to know which party he is. He told me, listen, I am a full supporter of Simon. That his first oath was in IPOB, his last oath now is in the Liberation Army, autopilot for life, that this is where he will die. So the man looked into my eyes to see if I will waver, if I will shake, so that he will know either he can go deeper with me or stay alive. So I looked at him as a strong man. And he was just calm and quiet and continued. I have been in the bush for more than this and that. I just came out and he was narrating stories to me. The next, my coordinator saw the story and he then came to the front and wanted to interrupt us. When the man left, he said, you see, suffering that man. I know that is what he's telling you. My PM, you are putting so much fear in Aba here. I don't know if someone is recording me, but in Aba here, the army is so afraid. There are at least the list of the checkpoints here. I wouldn't know if there are more than four. And the one at the junctions, the army, even at this fake announcement of sit at home, the army will keep distancing the machines and keke. They will distance them. They will distance them today. Tomorrow you'll be coming back to go and enter your bike. You will see that the distance have increased an extent and have increased another extent. The barricade.
That will not save those terrorists. It will never save them. They will remember them.
It is a pity that they will use this human shield, my PM. They use this human shield because if anything happens there, you see, they know what they are doing, because if anything happens there, then the ordinary civilian will be touched, and that's where we live. You see? And when they want to pursue you, They will use this their button and hit the keke person's glass or break your tire, so they do instill fear in you to move back. Thank you, my PM. We are seeing you. We don't talk. We don't need to talk too much because we are powerless and we don't want anybody to harm us. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And Aba have been taken by the Biafra government. There is nobody in Aba, no criminals element are not there. The remaining one will be taken care of. Thank you.
Thank you, PM. We go to Hello Biafra. Hello Biafra, are you ready? You're not ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Yeah, fire on, please.
Hello, Honorable Prime Minister. I greet everyone. Indeed, it is a very lovely day for me. This is my first time, you know, having been given the opportunity to speak on this platform. So, I just want to thank... Am I audible?
Yes, we can hear you.
So, I just want to express my sincere happiness. Do you know how excited we young people are, especially those in the Afanja land? When I'm walking on the streets, I'll just remember that I've not checked my Prime Minister's page to see any update on any woto-woto. So I just want to encourage him for what he's doing. And I want to tell him that he's doing well and God will protect him for us. Thank you very much. That's all I have to say.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, well, we come to Amos. Amos 3, verse 3. Are you there? Amos 3, verse 3. You're not ready. Win-win, over to you. Amos, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, right.
Yes, I'm ready.
Amos, right on.
Good evening, everyone in the house.
Devo.
And good evening, Prime Minister. In fact, I'm so excited for being here tonight because this is my first time to join a speech with Prime Minister.
Thank you. Do you still want to support Prime Minister even when he is from India?
No, I have never once said that maybe you're from anywhere or something, because I've been following you since 2001, and I know who you are, I know what you are doing. So, because actually I'm in Afanja land, but I'll be following
okay,
all
so
what
you
are
so
doing.
So you don't mind even if I'm from New Delhi in India?
I'm not even believe that maybe you are in India or whatever.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
No. So actually what I hear for is that I'm Onyegede guy, but I'm living in Ibadan here from Benue State. So then I'm fully support of what you are doing since 2021. So what I'm here to say is that I think Igede is going to be part of Biafra. So we are fully support.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Thank you. Win-win, over to you.
Yes. Good evening, my able Prime Minister. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Right on.
Thank you. Good evening, my able Prime Minister. And good evening, my Minister of Information and Deputy. My Prime Minister, I have two questions, and one is just to appreciate you for what you did concerning our brother, for those who were born in Onasata, in Obiago. We used to call him Bariwamba, Jaja. You know, the terrorists shot him more than 7 bullets and then dropped his body on the van. Thank you so much for the action you took. Today, sit at home was massively complied in formal Enugu State. I want to thank you so much for all you have been doing to our people, especially in this old Enugu State. I say may God Almighty bless you. Now, my second question is, we know Europe as one of the most, you know, law-abiding, you know, countries. My question is, we have identified some people who are laying threats, calling you out, calling Simon Ekpa this, Simon Ekpa criminal, this and that. My question is there any lawsuit that can be, you know, followed up against them while they are in Europe. Some of them, we know their address in Europe there.
As a matter of fact, one is open. Case is open, and so, but I will not discuss it here. And he knows himself. So, and I've pressed charges against him, where he was making video and calling me terrorist. So he should go and prove how Simon Ekpa is a terrorist. The case is on, and the police has opened a very strong case against him. Thank you.
Thank you so much, my Prime Minister. Because I remember when our leader Mazin Amikan said that our men have turned into gossip people. Some of our men, as Asinawa and Uchog, they have now turned to women, gossip everywhere. I want you to please do this for me. Show some of them example on how it's being done. Thank you so much.
This one will definitely be used as an example. I can never ever, they even ask me if I agreed to have a settlement. I said no. Let him go to court and prove how I'm a terrorist, because he has to prove that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Freedom Bound. Over to you, Freedom Bound.
Hello, good evening, everyone. I don't divest or radio since.
Abeg, why you? Take some more water. Cool down.
Everybody has been talking since, but I don't they pay me. Hey, good evening, PM. Good evening, everybody. And, your protocols.
Rafael, this person that you put in face that look like, what is that horror movie? that baby where they kill people. What is the name again?
Chucky.
can you remove this Chucky, please, from the screen?
before PM go the dream rubbish this night.
Before I go river, go push up there.
Should I continue?
Yes, continue.
Thank you. You, Vlad, I don't even know what to say. My hand don't pay me, but I don't know whether there will be enough time, because there's a lot of things to say. First of all, greeting is not enough. You know, we Biafrans, there's one thing about us that anytime we see, like Onyendu or Normally say, anytime we see the truth, we don't find it difficult to identify with it. So I was one of the, let me say, the pioneers of IPOB. In the heart of darkness. So a lot of things transpired, and even before our PM took the mantle, I've already saw some things, and I say no, this is not it, and I just have to recuse myself like Bita Nyako. So IPOB was not formed by Onyendu to get Biafra. Let me put that one straight. A lot of people shouting IPOB carrying flag. They don't know what IPOB is. Most of them don't know. So, for security purposes, some of us, veterans, pioneers, we keep quiet. First of all, the intention of forming IPOB, that is why Onyendu registered it. Because, okay, just imagine, our PM doesn't need to go and be registering Biafra anywhere. Now, you don't register government. Government is recognized. They are registering IPOB because IPOB was an organization with an aim of sensitization, not a government. And the time of sensitization has passed. Do we need to go and be registering Biafra now? We don't register countries now. They only recognize countries as an entity. So a lot of things transpired, especially, let me not take your time. You know, some other time I will be giving some information that, you know, it's not meant for public consumption, because here it's recorded. 2016. Are you listening, everyone?
We can hear you.
Yes.
Throw your question. Okay. Just like you said, a lot of time.
Yes.
Throw your question to the PM.
My question, what do I want to ask him? I don't want to ask him anything. My question is that why can't he appoint me to be attending to all these foolish questions that they used to ask him? When the other idiot said that he promised him that Biafra will come. Who told him that Biafra will come in on the second? Yeah, I don't understand. Onyendu, please, some of these questions, appoint me to be attending to them. I have a lot of things to tell them. Ndiofe Mano don't have sense. You know, the hatred, I don't, you know, sometimes the problem we have as Biafrans is that we only believe that until we offend somebody before somebody will hate me. No, I don't need to offend you to hate me. Once you see the light and it doesn't concord with your darkness, you should hate me. I'm not surprised of hating me now. Would you like what is not the same thing with you? So we are not the same. So let me just quickly say something about Ojukwu and Biafra one and all that. Chukwu Okike Abiamah can never allow Ojukwu to get Biafra. Should I tell you why? Had he been Ojukwu got Biafra during 1967 to 1970, there wouldn't be any difference between us and Nigeria till today. I tell you the truth. Ojukwu was a member of Scottish Grand Lodge. They didn't kill him. They took him to Africa. They say he fled. Ojukwu did not run away. They preserved their member and they brought him back and celebrated him by Shagari. And they convinced him to go and join politics. That was what they wanted to do to Onyendu. Onyendu was very wise. He had already read all these things. He studied Nigeria. He said he studied Nigeria for more than 19 years.
All right, wonderful people. Welcome back to this wonderful channel where we'll bring you back-to-back update and information as it is hot. In case you have not joined our social media handle, what are you waiting for? Kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, share, and also remember to on your notification button so that whenever our news drop, you will be the first. We'll collect them. Let's go down to the news proper as it is hot. In Enugu State, Enugu local government chairman has recruited 220 neighborhood watch operatives because of the insecurity that is ravaging the area. About 320 neighborhood watches have been created in Enugu State to be able to guard the community. A number of 302 security operatives have been recruited in Uzuwane, local government area of Enugu State, to curtail increasing crimes in the area. This was announced by the chairman of the council, Mr. Chijoke Ezugu. Ezugu said the initiative was to complement the efforts of the state government in checking crimes in the local government areas. The Whistler report that kidnapping, murder, and rape have been occurring in some parts of Uzuwane, making its farming potentiality wane. The council chairman said 20 neighborhood security personnel will be drawn from each of the 16 political wards of the council. He assured that his administration would not spare resources or relent in partnering with the state government and various security agencies to restore the security of lives and property, as well as the dignity of the council as the food basket of the state. All right, when I don't see as it happen for Enugu State, they have created a new security outfit there. But my own is creating the security outfit might not be able to stop whatever that is happening there, even though it will go at a length to help. But the main issue is that the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, should be released. And I believe that if he is released, most of all these things will curtail themselves, because that way we'll know who is who. As it is, Abia State is on fire right now as some gunmen attack army checking point in Abia State. Gunmen attack an army checking point early on Wednesday at Ekenobizi, a border community between Abia and Imo State, Omumokpara, Umuahia South local government area, killing two soldiers. Gunmen attack an army checking point early on Wednesday at Ekenobizi, a border community between Abia and Imo State, in Umuokpara, Umuahia South local government area, killing two soldiers. A military source who spoke on the condition of anonymity said the attack occurred around 6:18 a.m. The gunmen arrived in a white Lexus 350/400 model, although the exact number of attackers could not be confirmed. Confirming the incident in a press release on Wednesday, Lieutenant Colonel Jonah Nguakalo of the Joint Task Force Southeast Operation Udoka said the early hours of today, 13th November 2024, troops of the Joint Task Force Southeast Operation Udoka deployed at a checking point along Umuahia Owerri Road in Umuahia South local government area of Abia State came under attack by the Edidanti's group, Indigenous People of Biafra, and its arm affiliate, the Eastern Security Network. The Chief of Defense Staff, General Christopher Godwin Musa, has deployed a contingent of soldiers to the troubled Ogi local government area in Kebbi State following attack by a new terrorist group known as Rukarawa. As it is in Abia State, Baradia, where the men of the NIG army clashed face to face with the men of the Biafra Liberation Army or the Eastern Security Network. And according to the information dropping, is that two NIG soldiers lost their life, and we are yet to know the name of these soldiers that lost their life. As that one is happening in Abia State, in Kebbi, the Lukarawans are terrorizing that environment. They say the group recently attacked Mera village, killing over 15 people. The deployment follows an urgent appeal from Kebbi State Governor Dr. Nasir Idris. He asks for federal support to curb the group's violent activities. In an audacious and significant move geared towards recalibrating the economic landscape of Cross River State, Governor Bassi Edet Otu recently presented the 2025 Appreciation Bill to the State House of Assembly. This is happening live in River State. Dubbed the budget of sustainable growth, the proposed budget stands at an impressive $498 billion, representing a remarkable 98% increase from the previous fiscal year. The ambitious financial plan seeks to address critical needs while promoting sustainable growth across various sectors, exemplifying a proactive approach to governance in a challenging economic climate. The 2025 appropriation bill is characterized by a sustainable allocation towards capital projects with $328 billion, 60% dedicated to infrastructure and long-term investments, while $170 billion, 34%, is set aside for recurrent expenditure. The strategic allocation reflects a commitment to building a sustainable future for Cross River State, as articulated by Governor Otu during his budget address. This one is happening live in River State. Of course, you can see how much these people are proposing for their bill. And upon that, no road, no electricity, no good network, and the state is still debilitated. But kudos to the people of River State. There is a little effort there, but still upon that, the government parastatal still embezzled the money. In Benue State, Benue government to establish strategic rain reserve centers. Of course, you know that the man in Benue State now is a reverend father from the Catholic Church, and I believe maybe, and this is another time, a reverend father is taking over government in Benue State. It has not been a recurrent event in other states, but for Benue State, it has been the same. The Benue State government is set to establish strategic grain centers to purchase farm produce directly from farmers in the state. This was disclosed on Tuesday by the Managing Director of Benue Investment and Property Company, BIPC, Dr. Raymond Asemeka, during a meeting with key stakeholders in the agricultural sector. He said the initiative is ensure that farmers receive value for their money. All right, welcome back. I've been taking you around from one state to the other, bringing you information as it happened in some of these different places. And that is why I'm here for you. And once again, if this is your first time of joining us on this wonderful channel, kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, and share. As it is today, the body of the late Army General Lagbaja goes home. The Nigerian Air Force plane NAF 918 carrying the body of the late COS landed at the presidential wing of the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, at around 12:15 p.m. The body of the late Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Tareed Lagbaja, has arrived in Abuja, where he will be buried on Friday. The Nigerian Air Force plane NAF 918 carrying the body of the late COAS landed at the presidential wing of Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, at around 12:15 p.m. All right. This is an example for everybody that whether big, whether small, whether mighty, or whether the low, one day, death is the portion of everybody. And one of his Botewan Fibo is lamenting that what is happening around Igbo land, that where other tribes go and go freely, it is very difficult for them. But let's go down to the food tale of the information, as I will bring it to you, and also you will see the name of the person who lamented, where every other Nigerian will scale, the Igbo man will find it very difficult to scale Obi Agocha, the member representing the good people of Ikuano Umuahia Federal Constituency of Abia State. Honorable Obi Agocha has blamed the Nigerian government due to the manner Igbos are being treated in the country, noting that where every other Nigerian will scale on certain circumstances, the Igbo man will find it very hard to scale. Honorable Obi Agocha made this disclosure during the interview on Arise Television while reacting to the continuous detention of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. He went on and noted that it appears that there are two sets of rules in the country, one for other Nigerians and the other for the Igbos. He went on and urged the federal government to release Nnamdi Kanu the same way Sunday Igoho was released. He said, where every other Nigerian will scale on certain circumstances, the Igbo man will find it difficult to scale. Furthermore, the lawmaker made it known that there will be no tribe in Nigeria that is more patriotic than the Igbos, noting that Igbo are seen in different parts of the country, living and doing their businesses unlike other tribes in the country. In addition, he urged the Nigerian government to treat Igbos like other Nigerians, stating it clear that nobody is more Nigerian than the other. All right, this is coming from Honorable Agocha, who is representing the Ikuano in Abia State. Then, of course, you know that whenever election is coming by, these people tend to use Mazen Nnamdi Kanu as their billboard. And as it is, election is also approaching. The same thing, who knows the ambition of Agocha? This one is visiting Mazen Nnamdi Kanu because Soludo Charles of Anambra State did it. Even the late Ifeanyi Uba did the same thing. Because whenever Ndibo wants to pursue a political career, you see them making sure that they become well-known with Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. And if Nnamdi Kanu is so much important and plays a big role in their political destiny, why should he be taken as a nobody? Meanwhile, this is where I'll be winding down the curtain. And if this is your first time of joining us on this wonderful channel, go ahead, sub, like, and comment. Thank you. God bless you. What we are seeing is altogether different. Let's go down to the full detail of the information so that you can see what these Lukarawas are all about. Some of you might say, Nyokopus, why are you bringing this kind of news to your platform? Because this thing does not concern Biafrans and the rest of them. Remember the issue of the Fulani herdsmen that started just like play? Remember that fire that lights the candle is the same fire that can light the forest. As it is, the Fulani herd has started little by little. It was something that was happening in the Middle Belt, Benue, Makurdi, and the rest of them. And the people in the eastern part thought that maybe it's not part of their concern and the rest of them. But as it is now, you and I know that the people in the end part of Enugu State, like Iharamofo and the rest of them, are not going to their farms anymore. The people in some parts of Anambra are not going to their farms anymore. The people in some part of Abia State are not going to their farms anymore. Even in Delta State, these people are moving from one state to another, occupying places. Go to Okigwe in Imo State. Some of the people there are not going to their farms anymore. It's either when you go to your farm, you are being kidnapped, you are being harvested, or something like that. Some of these things happens in this country where you and I reside. As of now, even as we are waiting for the independence of the indigenous people of Biafra for their referendum, we are still in Nigeria and we have to talk about the things that concerns Nigeria until the day of the independence. A senior fellow of the Extremism Policy Unit at the Tony Blair Institute of Global Change, Bulama Bukati, said on Monday that the Lukarawa insurgent group has been surveilling communities and military formations in the northwest. Bukati, a human rights lawyer, stated this while appearing as a guest on Channel's Television Politics Today. Last Thursday, Director of Defense Headquarters Media Operation Major General Edward Buba identified the terrorists as a group originating from the Republic of Niger following a military coup in the country. Punch Online reports that barely 48 hours after the announcement by the military, the terror group attacked a Meratan and Agui local government area of Kebbi State, killing at least 15 people. However, Bukati, who has researched the Boko Haram insurgency for many years, argued that the armed group is not a new one, as speculated. Bukati further disclosed that aside from possessing sophisticated weaponry, the insurgents are also using drones to monitor activities in military formation and communities within their domain. He said not only do they have heavy weapons, but they also have drones and are surveilling village and military formation with them. I think we should take the security threat in a region already divided by bandit violence very seriously. He continued, their ideology is not different from Boko Haram, except that they present themselves more like police because they claim not to want to kill the people. They say they are only fighting the government and its apparatus. This exposes an extreme violent extremist ideology. But the good news is that my research so far has revealed that they have not been accepted by the communities. I have not found an example of local young people joining them. They are still foreigners, but they are large in number based on the information I'm getting. The sentiments were echoed by the Public Secretary of the Arewa Constitutive Forum, Prof. Tuko Mohamed Baba. Mohamed Baba, who also confirmed that the terrorists were not a new group, alleged that the Department of State Service is aware of their activities. The SEF spokesman further warned that if the insurgents are not stopped from attempting to assert their authority in the Northwest, they may begin enforcing the closure of schools and clinics. He said, everything Bulama said is true. It is consistent with our information because I have carried out research in that area. Two, it should be a cause of concern because this is not a new terror group. It emerged between 2017 and 2018. At least the DSS is aware of it. At that time, we thought they had been chased out, only to discover it was a deal for them to leave or be attacked. So they decided to leave and got rid of the cattle they possessed. We don't know whether they took the cattle from the people. They are trying to establish a local and foreign justice administration system in these communities. We cannot allow that if we are talking about Islamic law. Sokoto has Sharia law, but this is not the type of Sharia law they are practicing. They intervene in disputes and enforce rules. We fear they will go further, like closing schools and clinics. All right, welcome back. You might be wondering where all these things are happening. To shock you, this is happening in Nigeria. This is not happening maybe somewhere in the Middle East, maybe somewhere in Palestine, somewhere in Bahamas or the rest of them. No, this is happening right under our nose in Nigeria, that foreigners can cross the border, come in, create a government in a country that is not their own and start enforcing laws by themselves. You know, in other words, you can call these people the crusaders, because that is what they are. According to them, they are there to defend the people, but they are not there for the interest of the people. I think that Nigeria has to understand this, and as fast as possible, the government starts doing something to alleviate the poverty that is ravaging the nation. Without that, I'm telling you, a lot of insurgency will be coming in, because go to that northern part of Nigeria, you will find that the people that are the structures there, the people living there are in dilapidated form. And they can accept anything that is given to them as long as these people have posed to be crusaders, people who are fighting the government, making sure that the rights of the people get to them. And everybody wants a savior. the Muslims followed Muhammad because they believe Muhammad is a savior. The Christians follow Jesus Christ because they believe that Jesus Christ is a savior. The Buddhists are following Buddha because they believe he's their savior. The Krishnas are following Krishna because they believe the Krishna is their savior. So humanity is practically looking for savior. But some of these things are not seen in the Western part of the world, Europe and America and the rest of them, all these developed countries.